Good evening. Merry Christmas, everybody. We celebrate the birth of the Lord Jesus Christ together tonight. Jesus is magnificent and worthy to be praised. But you see, at first glance, one might think Jesus was just a great teacher. And in fact, he's the greatest teacher of all time. One might think that Jesus was just a very good man who had come to save us from our sins. And we know that he was the only perfect and sinless man who has ever lived. But the whole truth? We're celebrating the ultimate proof of God's love. Jesus wasn't just a teacher. Jesus wasn't just a man. He is God. His love is so deep for us that he left his glory to dwell among us. How deep the Father's love for us.
Savior in a manger lay. This love exchange that seemed so great restores us to our
It's that time of year again. It's getting colder outside, the days are growing shorter, and we're counting down the days until our seasonal festivities begin. For many of us, we go to parties, we buy gifts, we take our children to visit Santa Claus. We love these special traditions. But do we give Jesus, our Savior, the praise and adoration that He is due? To find the true meaning of Christmas, one has to go back about 2,000 years to a little town called Bethlehem. Jesus' birth is the foundation of this holiday. And more than 2 billion people will celebrate this occasion this year. Let us always remember, Jesus is the reason for Christmas.
Christmas is here, families will gather, rooms filled with laughter, and the world will be filled with love. Gifts will be given around the tree. Will they know the reason is you? Will they know?
At Christmas, we all consider the manger. However, I cannot help but consider the cross. In particular, what it cost the Father to give up His beloved Son to a torturous death on a cross. Most of all, I think about my own part in that event, because it was my sin that nailed Him there. Those words should bring all worshipers' minds not only back to the fact of their own sin, but also the glorious salvation brought about by Jesus Christ. This sweet baby was pure love. Did his young mother understand? This deep, deep love would soon save the world, and His name is Jesus.
Every time I say Now you may be asking the question, what's this have to do with me? Why did a baby have to be born? Why did God send his son to be born of a virgin? What's all of this mean? Maybe we need to go back to the beginning. You see, from the very beginning, God has had a plan. God had a plan to create a people to be the recipients of His love. A people that He could lavish with an extravagant, deep, deep love. A people who would reciprocate that love to Him, who would worship Him and adore Him. You see, in God's Word, the Bible, we read in Genesis 1, that in the beginning, God created all that we know. He created the heavens and the earth. He created the trees. He created the sea. He created the birds, the bees. He created all that exists. And He said, this is good. But then He created man and woman. And He said, it was very good. Because He created man and woman, mankind, to be the objects of this deep love. Unfortunately, we know the story. Man began to believe a lie instead of the truth of God's love and chose to sin against God. Man fell from the grace of God. That relationship that man was created for was broken. But God would not allow sin to destroy His plan, because He did. He did have a plan. So God promised mankind that one day He would make all things right. And so along came a man named Abraham, and God called Abraham to be the father of a people that would be the recipients, the objects of His love. His people, God's very people. And unfortunately, the cycle repeated itself over and over again. God would express His love to them, and they would choose to worship themselves and others instead of God. But God had a plan. You see, God, through the prophets, told people and tell us today that there would come a Messiah, one who would make all things right, one who would pay the price for our sin. And then the prophets were silent. For some 400 years, God was silent. He didn't speak to His people. But God may have been silent, but He was not inactive. God was active in the world. And when the time was right, He called to a man named Zechariah and to his wife Elizabeth. And He told them that they would have a son. Even though she was very old and way beyond childbearing years, told them that they would have a son and they would name him John. And he would prepare the way for the Messiah, the one who would be the sacrificial lamb of God. And God chose a young child, a young girl named Mary, to be the mother of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The Holy Spirit came upon Mary and she conceived. And as we have shown tonight through the drama and heard through the music, she had a child. And as was told to her by the angel, she named him Jesus. Jesus came and He lived a perfect life. He is God in the flesh, God incarnate. And He lived a perfect life to die a death for you and I. To die in our place, to pay the price for mine and your sin, for the sin of all mankind. You see, Jesus went to the cross and was crucified because of our sin. But the wonderful thing is, the cross could not hold Him. The grave could not contain Him. Jesus Christ from the third day rose again, and He lives. And because He lives, you can live too. You see, God had a plan. And no matter what we did, no matter what would happen, God had a plan to create a people to be the objects of His love, to love and to be loved. And Jesus is calling out to you tonight to trust in Him, to follow Him, to believe in Him and live by faith to say, Lord, I surrender my all to You. It doesn't matter how many sins you have committed. It doesn't matter what you've done. Jesus loves you, each and every one of you. And I want you to join me in prayer. And if the Lord has spoken to you tonight and you're ready to give your life to Him, I want you to pray with me. Let's pray together. Father God, I am a sinner and I need your forgiveness. I want to receive the love that you prepared for me in Christ. So today, Lord, I turn from my way and I turn to you. I turn to Jesus. I accept the free gift of salvation. And I want to follow you all the days of my life. I want to be loved and I want to love as I have been loved by you. Father, may I make a difference in the lives of those around me. Father, we pray these things in Jesus' name, saying thank you, Lord. Amen.
Has not been broken. Who here among us is without guilt or pain? So oft abandoned by our transgressions, if such a thing as grace exists, then grace was made for lies like this. There are no strangers, there are no outcasts, there are no orphans of God. So many fallen, but hallelujah, there are no orphans of God. Find affection. Come all ye weary, come and lay down your head. Come ye unworthy, you are my brother. Such a thing as grace exists, and grace was made for lives like this. There are no strangers, there are no outcasts, there are no orphans of God. So many fallen, but hallelujah, there are no orphans of God. Oh, blessed Father, look down upon us, we are your children.